Manmarie from brambleberry.com. Thanks so much for joining me today. Today, we're going to be making this rose clay and charcoal soap. This rose clay soap is scented with Rosehip Jasmine, one of Brambleberry's really early on fragrances. And this fragrance has stuck around because it is a wonderful rose smell that smells young and fresh. It's more like a pink rose. And then the jasmine notes in there really help to enliven it and freshen it up without making it smell overbearingly floral. It's a real crowd pleaser. One of the considerations in this soap is, of course, the charcoal. First of all, charcoal is lighter than air, so when you're handling it, make sure you are really careful not to sneeze or blow it all over, because it's not very much fun to clean up. The charcoal is done for our cool lines in here. Another thing to consider with this recipe is you're going to be using clay. Now, clay is wonderful because it absorbs moisture, right? Like, that's why it makes such a good skin-clearing mask. You know what it does in your soap? Also absorbs moisture. And so if you don't pre-mix the clay, which is a little bit of water, it can lead to cracking on the top of your soap as the clay absorbs the excess water in the soap. Crazy, right? So the usage rate is 1 teaspoon of clay to 1 tablespoon of water, just to kind of mix it up, get all that extra moisture in there so the clay doesn't crack or dry out your soap. Now, the rose clay does make a slightly more natural color than this. I'm boosting up this color with a little bit of fired up fuchsia. Now, if you're wanting an all natural bar of soap, don't use the fired up fuchsia, and instead of rosehip jasmine, go with an essential oil, and that would make this entire recipe totally natural. So let's go ahead and get started. To make things easy, I'm using the Brambleberry Lots of Lather. I love using Lots of Lather Quick Mix because all the work's already been done for me. All I've got to do is pop this in the microwave and melt it, and then I'm ready to go. So now it's time to get started. My oils are pre-measured, and I've already got my lye water mixed with a little bit of sodium lactate. That sodium lactate's going to help that soap pop out faster and easier in the end, especially because I'm using a silicone mold. And the most important thing, of course, is that I'm suiting up for safety, that children and pets are not in the area, and that I'm working in a well-ventilated area. And suiting up for safety means gloves, goggles, long sleeves, long pants, closed-toed shoes. And here we go. So first things first, I'm going to pour my lye water just gently into my soap. Gonna burp my stick blender just so I don't have any air that ends up in the stick blender. And after I get to a pretty nice thin trace, I'm gonna add my rose clay and with the stick blender in there so I can really make sure that the rose clay is fully incorporated in. So my soap is emulsified, but it's definitely not a trace yet, so I'm gonna go a little bit longer. Now we're at a pretty decent trace. I'm going to add my rose clay in my water. I can see though, since I've mixed it, that my rose clay has fallen to the bottom just a little bit. So I'm just gonna really quickly re-emulsify this and make sure that I have the clay and the water evenly mixed in. And now stick blend it real quick. That is such a beautiful color. I do want it to be just a little brighter, so I'm gonna go with 1 full teaspoon of this fired up fuchsia that I've already got pre-mixed into just a little bit of oil. And this is a 1/2 teaspoon, so I'm gonna do 2 of these. And that's just gonna give it just a little bit of kind of color burst. So this got really bright, but you can see that it does calm down, so don't worry. You didn't just make your beautiful romantic rose soap into something crazy neon. And now I'm gonna add my fragrance, and this fragrance behaves really, really, really well. You can totally stick blend it in if you want. I'm gonna whisk mine in just to give myself a little bit of extra time to work with this on camera. And I'm using a 1/2 ounces of that Rosehip Jasmine, and it's performing beautifully. Absolutely no kind of striping, no clumping, no nothing. It just smells wonderful. For this project, I'm using the Brambleberry silicone mold, and because I really do want this to kind of look a little more rustic, I actually want a thicker trace. I don't really want my layers to be exactly even. I really want it to look like I intentionally made kind of peaks and valleys, so I'm gonna stick blend this until it gets to a thicker trace. So now you'll really get to see how well behaved this fragrance is. Ooh, did you hear that? Heard definitely heard some air bubbles going in. So now I'm just gonna give this a jiggle, move this to the middle. So I'm just gonna pour about a third in. I do see some air bubbles, so I'm gonna give this a little jiggle as soon as this is in. So now I'm just gonna give this a little bit of kind of waiting time in there so I can start giving this some just a little bit of texture differences, because I don't want this to have lines that look straight. I want this to be intentionally messy, so that way it looks like mountains and valleys and peaks, and not like I did lines, but they didn't go perfectly. So now I'm gonna use this little duster to try and get my charcoal through evenly. Now, remember I mentioned charcoal is really light, so if you want, you could wear a mask for this. I tend not to because I don't breathe it in. But if you're concerned at all, you could wear a mask. And you know, honestly, a lot of soapers end up wearing masks anyways when they soap, especially if they're not working in a well-ventilated area. So totally up to you. I'm trying really hard not to get the charcoal down the sides, because what happens with the charcoal goes down the side, and I just got a little down the side, you end up with kind of charcoal down the whole side of your soap. But I want to get really even texture, so doing that. So now I'm going to put this to the side gently and carefully, because again, charcoal is lighter than air and it gets all over everything. So now I'm just going to take my giant spatula spoon and I'm just going to kind of plop carefully, and I will even this out and I will texture in just a minute. We're at a nice thick trace because, well, I brought it to a real thick trace, and this is exactly what I would expect. So now we're just gonna kind of doot. And now I'm just gonna give it just a little bit more over here, and now I'm just gonna texture again, right? This is definitely not an even line anymore because we have such thick trace, but I want it to really have some cool peaks and valleys. So texture, texture, texture. And then it'll be time to put on my charcoal. I cannot wait to cut this. It smells so good, it looks so good. All that putting on this mica duster does is help to prevent clumps and disperse a little bit more evenly. In one of my original books, I think in soap crafting, I used to blow to get all the charcoal on evenly. And I have since then determined in my infinite cleaning wisdom that blowing the charcoal is actually more trouble than it's worth. I would rather just have kind of thicker charcoal mounds in here than blowing the charcoal does. And I can see that I've got a little bit more that I need to do over here. And again, it's not that big of a deal. It's soap, so no one will know what your original design was. And I just tossed a bunch in here, so that'll be interesting. One of the things with charcoal that I do like is that, unlike black iron oxide, it is definitely a little bit more forgiving when it comes to lathering black. Black iron oxide tends to lather black pretty easily. Charcoal is a little bit more forgiving, and it's probably because charcoal is water soluble. So you still get that really black color, but you don't end up with black streaking in the tub unless you've really overdone it and done a lot. So now I'm just gonna glop all of this in, gonna plop it down, and then I'm gonna texture on top, and we'll have a perfect consistency to texture with. So it's in, plop, plop, plop. Ooh. Just got a little bit of black on top, so I'm actually gonna do that and try and cover that just a little bit more, so that way we have just a straight pink on top if possible. Okay, and now it's time for my favorite part, which is the texture. So this is a beautiful, beautiful consistency, and I'm just going to, I think I'm just gonna mound in the middle. It's a classic, maybe I'll mound it two-thirds over. It's kind of a classic design. I love this texture, it's so beautiful. And that rosehip jasmine is just holding up nicely. So I'm gonna just wipe that down on the side. So that way, perfect. And now it's time to sprinkle on our rose petals. And so the rose petals can go wherever you want. For the batch I made earlier, I kind of put them all over. For this one, I think I'm gonna put it just on this side. So you can kind of do what you want with that. And then once the rose petals are on, I'll spray with some rubbing alcohol. And then put this on a heat pad. It's pretty cold at the Brambleberry Studios, so I want this to go through gel phase if possible. And with these rose petals, obviously they'll come off after the first wash or two, but you do want to just kind of press just a little bit just to get them to stick into the wet soap. So make sure your gloves are still on when you do that. And that's it. It's just time to spray with rubbing alcohol and put this baby aside for 24 hours on a heat pad. So I made this soap just about 3 days ago and it's ready to pop out now, partially because I use sodium lactate, which really helps to make the soap harder and more shiny. This silicone mold is so easy to unmold. First, you just pull gently away from the sides and then you push out slowly. I do notice there's a little bit of charcoal there, so keep in mind your fingers are gonna get a little charcoaly. So think about that when you're pulling this out so you don't get fingerprints down the sides. One of the things I'm noticing about this is it's just a little bit soft, so, but that's also because it's really cold in the studio and so I'm getting a little bit of soda ash because of the temperature differences, and it is just a little bit soft, but I am gonna try some cuts for you. Because there is the petals on the top, if I cut from the top down like this, what'll happen is the petals will stick to my knife and do drag marks. So I'm gonna try and avoid that by putting this on the side just like that and try giving it some cuts. Here we go. Okay, I'm gonna exhale. I do something called coring up, so kind of just like tighten your core so you can press down evenly. I can hear the kind of gumminess of this soap as it cuts. I see right now that there is definitely a gel phase line right in this area, which makes a lot of sense because, again, I told you it was uneven in terms of this temperature outside being pretty cold. Now this is the end though, so I'm not too worried about it. It's gonna end up going to a more full gel phase as we move kind of further into this loaf. And I also see that there's a few color striations, which I would expect with the temperature variations and the clay. But let's see what this looks like further down into some of these cuts. So I can see right now that my gel phase is getting better. The more kind of deep I get into the loaf. Like this gel phase went all the way through. Again, it's cold in here, so the ambient temperature is cold. So even though I did put this on the heat rack, it still didn't gel all the way through at the end. So keep that in mind when you're making any soap in the winter, is you always have to be thinking of insulation and the temperature variation. So I'm just gonna keep cutting these and then I'm gonna let this sit for 4 to 6 weeks so that it cures and dries and then it's ready to give away and sell. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up below. Of course, subscribe to our channel so that way you're notified every time we come out with a brand new video. And when you make this project or any projects, hashtag it BrambleOn on social so we can see what you create and you can inspire the rest of the maker community. Until next time, happy soaping. Ago, that just dates me, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah. Wow. You've been around a
forever.
Long time.
Just the fossil of soap making. Okay, try that again.
Okay.
Sorry.
Stop
spreading the news.
You'll probably want to, like, you know, get that a little bit.
I'm leaving today. Okay. I'm gonna
and then this, I think
be
that's
a New York, New York.
One light teaspoon
of the really of
the fire
wow.